Hello friends, in the last lecture we have learned about the introduction about ARDL model. We have also learned the various steps that are being involved while running the ARDL model. So the first step that we learned is that we have to check the stationarity of the variables, and whenever we are checking the stationarity, your variables should be stationary at level or at first difference. That means variable should be stationary, or you can say integrated at level or integrated at first difference. If you find the combination of I0 and I1, that means we can apply the ARDL model. Second step, we have learned that we have to select the optimum lag. We have already learned what you mean by lag. That means we have to see on which previous value our variable is dependent. That means your dependent variable yt is dependent on yt minus 1 or yt minus 2 or xt minus 1, xt minus 2. So on which previous lag your today's value of dependent variable is depending. So that means next step is to calculate the optimum lag. Once we have done with these two steps, we will move towards the application of the ARDL model. So first of all, let us check about the stationarity of variables. I have this data set where you can find the FDI, foreign direct investment, exports, USD INR, imports, inflation rate and interest rate. Let us take three variables over here. That means export, inflation rate and interest rate. So I want to check the relationship between inflation rate, interest rate and exports. That means whether inflation and interest rate is impacting the exports or not. So my exports can be the dependent variable and inflation rate and interest rate will be my independent variables. So the first step, as we have discussed, the first step is to check the stationarity. So now in the last video also I have told you we don't have to convert it into stationarity. We just have to do the checking whether my data is stationary at level or my data is stationary at first difference. We have also done that how to check the stationarity. So for that I have to library. Let me first attach the file. And we have to library the package t-series. Now, once we have library the package, let us check whether my data is stationary and if it is stationary, at what level it is stationary. So for that, we have to check by augmented Dickey Fuller test. So that is the command is adf.test and let me write exports. Now over here you can see the p-value is less than 5% level of significance. That means my data is stationary at level. So let us write over here, your export is stationary at I0. Now next we have to take inflation rate. Now let us see whether it is integrated at 0 or it is integrated at first difference. So adf.test and inflation rate. Now you can see over here for inflation rate your p-value is 0.01. that means it is, the data is stationary. So I can say that my inflation rate is also stationary at level. Now third is my interest rate. Now let us see whether my interest rate is integrated at first difference or at level. So again let us check for interest rate, adf.test and interest rate. So now the p-value is 0.6881. So that means your data is not stationary. So my data is not stationary at level. So let me check whether it is stationary at first difference or not. So first of all, let me convert it. So I'll write d interest is equals to diff interest rate. Now let us check it, adf.test d interest. Now yes, now you can see the p value is 0.01. that means my interest rate is stationary at first difference. So now we can say that whenever we are taking these three variables, it is a combination of some variables, that means export and inflation rate are stationary at level and interest rate is stationary at first difference. So we get the combination of 0 and 1. So that means we can apply the ARDL model. So that means we have fulfilled the first condition, which says that your data should be stationary at either level or at first difference. So next step is we have to check the optimum lag. Now we have to check the optimum lag of these three variables. So let us check. If we have to check the optimum lag, for that we need a package library vars. Now we have library the package var. So let us check first of all the lag of exports. So the command will be var select and then you have to write exports. Now you can see the result over here. Now my result is in exponential. So let me convert this exponential first into the number. So whenever you have to convert the exponential into numbers, our command is options bracket scipen equals to 999. Okay, now if I'm going to write the command var select and exports, now you can see the exponential figure is converted into normal numbers. Now over here you can see the three parts or four parts, AIC, HQ, SC and FPE. That means on the basis of these four we can select our optimum lag for exports. In this it's saying 6, 6, 6 and 6. That means according to AIC your lag should be 6, according to HQ your lag should be 6, according to SC your lag should be 6 and according to FPE your lag should be 6. This is the selection what R has done, R software has done. Now let me tell you how we are going to select this, whether AIC, how we say that R is selecting that AIC should be 6. Now you can see that R has given the output for 10 lakhs. Now in that 10 lakhs we have to see, if we are saying about AIC, that means AIC information criteria, we have to see the smallest number. In whatever lag your smallest number will be there, we are going to select that lag. Now if you are going to see the first lag, your answer is 28.9605. If I am going to see the next part, it's 28.95, so it's smaller than 96. So second is the smallest. If I are going to compare 1 lag and 2 lag, second lag is the smallest. Now let's compare the next one. Third lag it says 28.955. again it is smaller than the second, so we select the third one. Now if we are going to see the fourth one, it's 28.9385, which is again smaller than third lag. So till now the fourth lag is the selection criteria. Now fifth lag it says 28.92, even smaller than that. Now if we come to the sixth lag, it's 28.78, even smaller than your fifth lag. Now seventh lag is 28.79, which is greater than your sixth. 8th is 28.79, again greater than your 6th lag, and 9th is 28.79, again greater than your 6th lag, and if you will see the 10th lag, it's 28.80, which is again greater than your 6th lag. That means if we are going to compare all the 10 lags, we will see that 6th lag has the smallest value for AIC information criteria. So that's why we have said that our lag selection is 6, optimum lag is 6. In similar way, you have to compare all the values of HQ also, and where whatever lag you are the smallest value you are going to get, you will say that is your optimum lag. This R is saying that HQ is 6, so let us check for HQ also. Sixth value is 28.83. Now let's see, first value is 28.97, which is more. 28.97, 28.98, 97, 97, again everything is more. If we see about 7th, 8th and 9th lag, 85, 80, 0.86, 28.87, 28.89, every value is more than 28.83. So 6th is your optimum lag. So in this way you have to select for every bar. Now let's take one more example. Bar select, and now we are going to check it for inflation rate. Now you can see over here the value is 1, that means lag value is showing over here is 1. So let us check it over here. For that AIC is -0.730. Now whenever the negative sign is there, if you are going to draw a number line, you will see that as the most greatest number will be the smallest number in the negative sign. So we have to see -0.73 will be smaller than -0.72. So you can say that the second, on second lag, your value is -0.72, again 0.72, 71, 70. That means numbers are increasing over here. 71, 71, 70, 69, 69. These are increasing. So -0.7302549 is the smallest among all the lag values. So that's why our optimum lag value will be 1. The same way you have to check for HQ, SC and FPE also. So this is the case whenever we are selecting the individual lag values for individual variables. But if you are going to select the lag values with a combination of two or three variables, that means whenever we are going to take the lag values of, let's say there are two independent variables, so we have to take the lag values in the combination of two independent variables. So then how we are going to check it? So again we have to take var select, and if there are more than one variable, so we will use the command data.frame, and now we can write the variables. Let's say in our example we have taken that inflation rate and interest rate will be our independent variable. So let us take as inflation rate and your interest rate. Okay, now you can see over here I have taken both the values for inflation rate and interest rate, and the combined lag is 3. AIC is showing 3. So let us check it over here. For third is -3.995, and if you are going to see all other values, at first lag 37, 392, 381, 95. So you can see all other values are greater than your third value, that is 3.9950. So this is my optimum lag. Now in this way you can see that AIC is showing that your optimum lag is 3, HQ is showing your optimum lag is 3. SC is showing your optimum lag is 2 and FP is showing your optimum lag is 3. So now there is a confusion that which optimum lag we have to take. So you have to back up with your literature, but normally we take about the AIC. So I'll take the optimum lag to be 3. So these are the ways how we can select the lag of the values. So that means once we have selected the optimum lag, my second step is done. So now the third step is apply ARDL model. So in today, in this lecture, we will end up at this moment. That means we have just checked the stationarity and we have just checked how to select the optimum lag. In the next video, I'm going to tell you how to apply the ARDL model. Thank you.